Joining us now is Canadian writer and filmmaker Pasquale Marco Veltri, whose new film, Drowning, is about to make its world premiere among this year's roster of Canadian independent films at the ICFF Film Festival on June 15th at the TIFF Bell Lightbox. Also with us in studio is Alys Crocker, who plays Mary. Welcome to What She Said.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us.
Drowning examines the psychological effects of being forced into prostitution at a young age. You wrote and directed this. What inspired you to embark on this particular project?
Well, years ago, it's funny how long things take. This is about 6 years ago now. We were trying to get a documentary off the ground on trafficking and the effects of that. And that kind of fell apart, and we were left with, you know, even looking into it affects you, because it's things people don't look into, they don't think about. You walk down the street, you see these signs, you're like, well, it doesn't matter, you keep walking. It's like right in front of our face. And then the idea stuck with me of, like, what would happen to someone who, you know, had a different childhood than we do. We grew up with, you know, love and support of your family. What happens when you take that away? One of the, you know, tenets we grew up with, the pillars of your life, is that you learn to love because you're loved as a child. What happens when that's not there and the people that are supposed to help and support you actually cause you trauma? So we have four or five characters in the film that respond differently to that trauma. Some, you know, continue to abuse others. Some pretend it's not happening. And others create delusions of escape.
There must have been a lot of research involved with this.
Well, at the time, there was quite a lot of talking to different groups that help and support the individuals. And because it was a documentary at the time, we were like, you know, had people lined up and things like that. We didn't get all the way to pre-interviews, but there were, almost 6 months of thinking it was going to be a documentary kind of project. And then it, over a year and a half, kind of just coming out as sort of what would happen to a character if they were affected by this type of abuse.
Okay, so it follows, as I understand it, a woman named Anna, who is a prostitute who learns to take control of her own life and live on her own terms, as it were. So, but Alys, you play Mary.
Yes, her sister.
Her sister. So
yes.
That's, tell us about this and how she fits into the whole.
So as Marco was saying earlier, they both grew up in a family home where they didn't have a lot of love and support, and they were abused. And I think they're good foils for each other because they show the juxtaposition to how different people can internalize different kinds of trauma and how it can affect them and how they learn to deal with it. So my character is the polar opposite in the way that she approaches this trauma and her use of it and how to create a new life for herself. I don't know how much I'm allowed to give away about it.
Give it all away.
Give it all away. Okay.
This isn't the Avengers.
So you don't actually think anything has happened to my character until about halfway through the movie. Mm-hmm. And then there's sort of a showdown between me and my sister where she's yelling at me and saying, like, can I say this?
Oh.
Okay. saying, like, why didn't they do it to you? Why weren't you abused like I was in our family home? And it's because I'm this happy-go-lucky, like, always positive person who has, like, a husband and kids, and I have the whole package. And then I break down and say, you don't think it happened to me? Maybe I'm just better at hiding it than you are.
Ooh.
I'm already starting to tear up here.
Yeah. Yep. So it was filmed in Toronto and around the GTA during the fall of 2016. So what was that process like for you?
Well, with a micro-budget film, everything takes a little bit longer. But it really is 2 years of raising money. Then you have luckily, we had about 25, 26 days of shooting. And we shot, you name a city in, you know, the GTA, we were there. We went up to Clinton, parts of Hamilton. So we basically, when I was writing, I wrote around locations I would have access to. Because when you're a micro-budget movie, your biggest expense is locations. Mm-hmm. So we didn't want to make the movie where you're in one house with six actors, which is what you're forced to make at the budget level that we're at. So we just leaned on all the people that we knew for locations, which is a trick you can only pull once. And so we ended up just being all over the city and all over sort of the Southern Ontario region for those 30 days. And then once you're done that part, then you move on to post, which takes longer depending on the amount of money you have. So really it was about 2 years of raising the money and writing and prepping it, then, you know, shooting took 30 days, but then The Post was another year and a half, and then even the process of promoting it. So every movie is like a small business that runs for 3 to 6 years, depending. Mm-hmm. So it's quite a long process.
Well, obviously, this whole project is a work of passion for you. I mean, you've been sort of involved with it for a number of years. What do you hope that people take away from watching this film?
Well, with any film, you just hope that it resonates. And we're hoping that we created something that is watchable. It's more of a slow burn psychological thriller. Because if you made something that was more realistic, that didn't have the pretty shots and all the locations and mm-hmm. kind of hiding some of the truths and make it seem a little bit more as if you're watching the delusions of the character instead of seeing their real life, it would be even harder to watch. So we're hoping that they take away what could happen to you, and you know, to not just be thankful for what you have, but to realize that this happens, and we should be a little bit more aware of it.
So Drowning celebrates its world premiere at the ICFF Film Festival on Saturday, June 15th. That's next week. What exactly is the ICFF Film Festival?
It is the Italian-Canadian Film Festival. They've been around for 7 or 8 years now, and what they do is they collect Italian films from all over the world, and they bring it to Toronto. And I think what was the math on it? There's 1.5 million Italian Canadians that they bring, basically like the Italian Oscar-winning films from Italy, bring them here, and other projects. They also have fashion shows and galas, and of course food.
So food.
Yeah. Italians,
good.
They take more food.
They take the tenets of food, family, and art, and put it all together and just bring it to Toronto.
So your films have screened internationally. What does it mean to you to be part of something here at home?
It's more important because when you travel, and it doesn't happen often because it takes so long. It depends on the film festival, and you can get a little lost. I remember years ago when we were lucky enough to have some international screenings in France and other places. Like, you're lost in a sea of filmmakers, and there's so many people there, and everybody's selling. And it's especially when it's much younger. So, you learn about, mm-hmm. it's like you're at an international auto show and everyone's selling. You have no idea what you're supposed to do. But when you're at a local film festival, we have 25 speaking parts, all local actors, and they're all able to come. And you can also have all the people that helped and support you over the years. And I was joking with someone that planning this, getting everyone together for the screening and the after party and all the elements of this was more complicated than my wedding.
Than your wedding?
And the movie, yeah.
But and the movie, yeah.
It's even a little bit more complicated. but it just has all of those elements where, you're just bringing the team back together.
Well, I'm got my head stuck on the food and the fashion and all the other stuff there. So you are actually, there are tickets.
The tickets are available at
www.icff.ca or at the box office. So where can people connect?
They can find us online. They can either directly find me at pmveltri.com, and hopefully there'll be a link there. You can go right to the webpage of the film festival, the icff.ca site.
And you
just go to June 15th, and you click through, and you'll find the tickets.
It's 2 p.m.
2 p.m. screening, which is nice.
Yeah.
And then you can eat.
We will, don't worry.
But buy some clothes.
Yeah. After that screening, where does it go? Where will people who can't make this be able to see it?
There's going to be a few other festivals coming up. We can't really talk about them right now.
Can't tell you. Well, you'd have to kill you.
Maybe. And then we're looking for a digital release in mid-November. We'll do another media push. And then, of course, it'll just exist online as films do now. Mm-hmm. So they have, it just stays online for you to find. So we'll be pushing it a few more times over the next few months, and then definitely another big push in mid-November.
So who plays Anna?
Anna's played by Laura Tremblay, and she just does everything.
She's lovely. I thought she was going to be here today. I miss her, but she's working on something else. But she's amazing.
She's just too popular.
Yeah.
She's always working. Yeah. So,
is it difficult to cast?
It's one of the we had a lot of help casting with Jules Casting and a bunch of other people, just because we wanted to have a diverse cast and make sure that we found the right person. And it was a long process. You dealt with, breaking down a certain, I'm not going to say hundreds, but there was close to 100 people that went down to like 4 or 5, and Laura just kept shining through. Because it's tough. This is a very hard role. Mm-hmm. Because when you have a lead character who isn't likable necessarily, it's hard for people to connect to them. And no matter what Laura was going through, what she was doing, you still connected to her.
All right. Well, thank you very much for coming in and telling us about it. Once again, it's icff.ca or at the Tiff Bell Lightbox box office. Too many boxes there.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.